हेलो इंजीनियर्स, इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द ऑक्सिलरी ब्लॉक, राइट? सो ऑक्सिलरी ब्लॉक इज यूज्ड विद द एमसीबी। इट मे बी सिंगल पोल, डबल पोल, ट्रिपल पोल और फोर पोल एमसीबी। इट इज ऑल्सो यूज्ड विद द कॉन्टैक्टर। इट मे बी फॉर लाइक इट मे बी पावर कॉन्टैक्टर और कॉन्टैक्टर फॉर द कंट्रोलिंग पर्पज। इट मे बी योर मॉड्यूलर कॉन्टैक्टर, राइट? सो वी कैन यूज अवर ऑक्सिलरी ब्लॉक विथ ऑल दीज इक्विपमेंट, राइट? So here you can see that this is my contactor and this is my auxiliary block. Okay, so what is the meaning of auxiliary block mainly? So here auxiliary block is used for the two purpose. The first one is for controlling and the second is it provides us the extra NONC. Okay, in your contactor there will be a limited NONC, right? But with the help of the auxiliary block you could get the extra NONC. I hope you got my point. So if you want the extra NONC, what you can do, you can use your auxiliary block at the side of the contactor or you can put it at the above of your contactor, right? Here you can see that then you will get here 2NO or 2NC. I hope you got my point. Same, I have here more contactors, so you can see, right? So here if I talk about this contactor, so you will see this is its block and this one is my contactor. Okay, and here you can also see that this is the pin of your block and this is the slot of your, what is this? This is the slot of your contactor which will be used to connect it together, right? So here we have connected our contactor with the block, right? And this contactor has a 25 ampere rating. It means that you can control up to 25 ampere load, right? Let's suppose if you want the extra controlling terminals, then what we can do, we can use the auxiliary block. Okay, and auxiliary block can be used for the indicator purpose, right? Let's suppose in the panel, or it can be also used for the interlocking purpose, right? So for the controlling purpose we can use our block anywhere, right? But in this video we will see that how we can connect block with MCB. Okay, here this one is my single pole MCB, right? Here you can see that, and this is my four pole MCB and this is my three pole MCB, right? You will see that in each MCB there is a one slot and which is cover basically, right? Here you can see that in four pole MCB there is a slot. In your single pole MCB also there will be a slot. Okay, I'll just show you this slot. Okay, just I'll put this cover outside and here you can see that there is a slot. Okay, are you seeing this one? That's good. And these slots are provided for the controlling purpose, right? Here you can see that you will get in each MCB there will be a slot. Okay, here in the four pole MCB here you can see there is also a slot, okay? And why these slots are provided? These slots are provided for the controlling purpose, right? Now I'll cover this slot, okay? And this, the block which I have that will not be cover or that will not be connect with this 4 pole MCB, right? And here you can see that I have a 3 pole MCB. Same, there is also a slot which you can see here, okay? That if you will on off, so here you can see there is also a slot and I'll also cover this one, okay? And there is a one thing as well, if there is something is given by the manufacturer, so there will be a some reason, definitely there will be a some reason that we must know, okay? In our case, if the slot is given here, so that slot has a purpose and the purpose is that you can use your block here, right? Here in this MCB, I'll connect my block, right? And in this block which I have, there is a common NONC, okay? And here you can see that 11, 12, 14. 11 and 12 is a NC and 11 and 14 is a NO. And this 11 is a common and that will be used for the your line, right? I hope you got this point. Okay, that's good. Now, I'll simply connect this. Okay, together, and here you can see one thing, there is a lever of your block and there will be also a lever of your MCB, right? And I'll connect both together. Okay, here you can see that I have connect that together. Now in MCB, we can use it as for the controlling purpose. Okay, let's suppose there this MCB is used within your panel and you want to see, okay, you want to show some indicator outside of your panel, so you can use this. Okay, and let's suppose if it will be on, so green signal will be there, and if it will be off, so red signal will be there. Okay, so with the help of your blog, that you can do. Okay, means your controlling you can be provided. Right, so that's how you can do the controlling. Okay, and this block can also be used for the, as I have already told you, for the extra NONC purpose. Right, and here you can see that my single pole MCB has been connected with the block. Okay, now I'll show you the simple connection. Okay, by providing here the indicator so that you could understood it in a better way and you can analyze it. I hope you understood till here. Okay, and here you can see that I have done the connection. Here I have the two indicators, the red and blue one. Now let's see the connection here first, right? This first one is my line wire, okay, and the common terminal, that one is my 11th one, right? Okay, and the second one is my 12th one, and the NC terminal that I am giving into the red indicator. Okay, this first one is my line wire as well. Okay, I hope you understood about it. And the second one is my NC that I am giving into the red one. Okay, and in the last, this is my 14th one, that is a NO that I am giving into the green one. Okay, I hope you understood till here. And the line wire that I'll control here, okay, means we will control the line wire here. Okay, I hope you understood till here. Okay, and if I talk about the neutral here, so neutral I have given here direct, and here I have made the loop, which you can see here. Okay, okay, now I on the power. So as I on the power, so you will see that my red indicator is showing. Okay, why? Because I have connected it with the NC1. Okay, and my MCB is off. As I on my MCB, so the green one will be connect. Why? Because that I have connected with the NO. Got it my point? And let's suppose this MCB is somewhere in the panel, okay, inside, and this indicator I have given outside. Okay, let's suppose as it trip, okay, MCB trip, so simply the red indication will be so. Okay, and you can simply understood that, okay, right now it has been trip, or this MCB is at the closed condition, and when it will be on condition, okay, so the green indication will be there. Okay, it is very very useful for the safety purpose as well. Got it my points? And here you can see one thing, I haven't done the connection with the MCB, but you can do that whether you want to control something or whether you want to connect it with your heavy load, that you can do here, right? So these auxiliary block you can use with the contactor as well, with modular contactor as well, as I have shown you earlier MCB that we have discussed here. Okay, the main purpose of this auxiliary block is that for the indication or for the controlling purpose, right? Okay, same these auxiliary block can be used with the your contactor, with your modular contactor, okay, MCB that we have already discussed here. Okay, and the purpose will be same. The purpose will be for the indicating purpose, for the extra NONC, and for the controlling purpose, right? And it is not used the for the power purpose. The reason is that it has a low current carrying capacity. Okay, so it will be used always where their low current capacity is there. Okay, I hope you understood about it. I hope you understood about the connections and the concept here, right? So that's all for the today's video. Okay, thanks for watching. Till then, keep learning. If you haven't subscribed our YouTube channel, press the bell icon so that you could get the latest notification. Thank you.